Hi everyone, you've probably heard about the fact that Facebook have now introduced a subscribe button. And this is really massive. It will make such a difference to you and your reach, your networking, your sharing on Facebook. Let me just take you over and show you how to enable the subscribe button on your personal profile. This is how you actually add it to your profile. Now, this is not anything to do with fan pages. This is to do with your personal profile. So it's to do with your networking, your sharing on your personal news feeds and your personal profile. And here you can see my profile. If you go over to the left, there is now a button that says subscriptions. If you click on this, it will take you to this page. Now it's showing you how many of your friends are actually using Subscribe. All these pictures up here are showing me how many of my friends are currently using Subscribe. And this is really new, so there's only 25 of my friends right now that are doing it. But there will be more, and this is going to really roll out when people start to know it's there. And the way to add it is to click here, Allow Subscribers. You now get this box, and it says, allow anyone to comment on your public updates. Now, when you have subscriptions, the only things that will be shared will be public updates. So if you're sharing things just with your friends, none of your subscribers will actually see those posts. I'll go into that in a little bit more detail in a moment. For now, I'm just showing you how you can turn it on or off. So you can allow that to be off, or you can tick it and allow it to be on. You can come back and change it any time. Notifications, do you want to know when people subscribe? So you can ask for notifications when anyone subscribes, you can ask for notifications when friends of friends subscribe, or you can say, I don't want any notifications at all. So for now, I'm going to tick anyone. I can come back in and I can change this. So let's click OK. I now have subscriptions added. Now, I won't actually see the subscription button in my own profile. If we go over to Mark Zuckerberg, and you can see over here, he has a subscribe button. Now, it's ticked because I've subscribed. I could come over here and unsubscribe if I wanted to. And you can see that already he has over 5 million subscribers, which means that people are going to start to see his updates, even if they're not his friend. If he shares his updates publicly, that is the key. Subscribers will only see updates that you have shared publicly. Now, if we have a look at this subscribe button, when you've subscribed to someone, you can then also choose, do you want to see all of their updates? Do you want to see most updates? Or do you only want to see important updates? Now, Facebook are deciding what makes the difference in these at the moment, and we'll find out a little bit more about that as we go forward with this subscribe button. I'm going to leave it on the default most updates for now. You can also say what types of updates. So, do you want to see life events? Do you want to see status updates? Photos and videos, and you can also see games. Now, I don't want to see games because I don't play games on Facebook, so I'm going to untick games. And if you decide that you don't want to see any more, you can unsubscribe as well. So that's how you choose what information you'll see from these people that you're subscribing to. So if I go back to my home page, go to my profile, I now have another button that says subscribers. So I will see there who has subscribed to me, as well as seeing where I have subscribed and who I've subscribed to. Now, if I click on subscriptions, I'll get a list of everyone I've subscribed to. And I can also here go in and change what I want to see and my updates. So it's easy. I don't have to go back and find Mark's profile again. I can just come here to my subscriptions and choose what I want to see and what I don't want to see. So that's how you add the subscriptions to your page. Now, like I said at the beginning, don't add it yet because I want to talk to you about the differences it's going to make and whether or not you want to add subscribe to your page. So I said I'd tell you a little bit more about subscribing and what you can do with it and what to think about. Well, if I go to one of my friends' pages, who I know has a subscribe button, Now, this is somebody that I'm friends with, and you can see here it's ticked to say that I'm friends. And it's also ticked to say that I'm subscribed. So all your friends are automatically now subscribed to you, which is actually really great because perhaps you've accepted some friends because you do a lot of business networking with them, but they're not really close friends and you don't want to share all of your updates with them. Well, now what you can do is you can unfriend them and they will stay as subscribers. So that means you can unfriend, they won't see any posts that you post specifically for your friends and your friends of friends, but they will still see all of your public posts. You can also, with each of your current friends, go into their profile, and on here, you've got the subscribe button, so you can now choose what you want to see and what you don't want to see from them. For instance, I don't see games, so I can untick games. So that gives you even more options. You can only have yourself 5,000 subscriptions. So you can only go and click subscribe on 5,000 other people's profiles. But as many people as want to can subscribe to you. That's unlimited. You also remember, because some people are saying, well, I don't want to allow subscriptions because then people will see everything and, this is getting a bit too open. I want more privacy, not less. You have more privacy. If you have subscribers, you can still choose what they see and what they don't see. When you go in here to create a new update, this is where you choose what people see. So over here, remember, as you post a new update, you can choose whether you want it to post publicly, which means your friends of your friends, and your subscribers will see it. Or you can choose your friends, which means that only your friends will see it, none of your subscribers. Or you can choose custom. We click on this, you can make this post visible to friends, friends of friends, specific people or lists, or just yourself. And you can also hide this particular post from certain people or certain lists. So it's giving you real control over who you share each post with. You can also go in here and you can choose one of your lists. So you might only want to share a post with people that are interested in social media, or perhaps you only want to share a post with the friends that you've put into a list that are old school friends, or people that live in a certain place and you've put those into a list. So this really does give you a lot of choice to really hone down and decide who you're going to share each of your posts with. Now, some people have said, well, why don't we have a subscribe on fan pages? You don't need one. If I go over to my page, anybody who's actually a fan on my page, automatically by clicking like, they will see my page posts, my page updates in their news feed. And pages that have liked me, if I log on here as my page, pages that you have liked, and so this happens for pages that have liked me as well. If I click on home, this is my page news feed, and in here, all I see are the updates from pages that I have liked as my page. So that's the same as being a subscriber. I've already liked the page as myself, and I see all of their updates through my personal profile news feed. I've liked pages as my page, and I see their updates through my page's news feed. And something really new that I have read about today as I was making this video is that apparently, in a few weeks' time, public people, so people who are personalities, who at the moment have had to have a fan page because there was no other way to have more than 5,000 people follow their updates and follow what they were doing. They'll soon be able to convert their business page, their likers, into subscribers of their personal profile. So they will no longer have to have a separate business page to be able to let people, their fans and people who want to follow them, keep up with them. Now, of course, if you're running a business, you still need to keep your business page. This is not a reason for taking off your business page, because your business page allows you to have a welcome tab. It allows you to use apps for contests. It allows you to promote your business, to sell from your page. But for personalities who aren't actually selling anything, they just have a lot of followers, this will be really great. And also for people like reporters, newspaper people who they're not selling anything, they're not running a business, but they have a lot of people that want to follow them. So this subscribe button really is a game changer. And if you've got any questions, come over to the How To Girl fan page and just pop them on the wall, and I'll answer them as best as I can for you. And I hope you've enjoyed that.